Let me light a candle. Let's do
warm musk and warm vanilla.
Today, because I can.
Don't light your own hand on fire. That is not handy.
Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video where I'm going to get ready to go grocery shopping. And I have some new things, so I thought, let's combine the two. I have something that I want to start with, and I'm basically going to see what else I want to do. Because I have this from Christian Odette, the Puffin Lipstick and the Kitten Liner. And I want to use these today. I also have some nice Malta Chromy goodness from VE Cosmetics. I have a palette from VE Cosmetics. I even have a palette from Alien Cosmetics. That I can kind of pull in. I have some stuff from 5050 Makeup. So it's basically going to be an indie brand video today. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love makeup just as much as I do, if you want to hear about brands that no one else is talking about, if you want to be inspired and entertained at the same time, and if you are slightly orcish, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, because I upload 4 videos a week. I'm going to start with the lippy. So, when I ordered this, when they brought the collection back, if you don't know who Mel is, it could be Mel Thompson. This is what she looked like. Sadly, she passed away a few months ago. And yeah, that's it. She passed away a few months ago. And the community has just lost a hugely gorgeous and precious human. Honestly, it was... Yeah, I will link her channel down below so you can go and check her out, because her channel is still online, her videos are still valid, and it is a great way to support the family as well, as is doing stuff like this, buying her collabs, you know, using any discount codes that she may have. She did not have one with Christian Odette, but there is a code for Christian Odette from my friend Tara, and I will link that code down below, because she will donate the profits that she gets from Christian Odette using her code to Mel's family. So she had 2 lippies and 2 liners. So she had the Puffin. Puffin was actually her nickname for her husband. Oh wow, this feels very, very luxe. It was her nickname for her husband, and he called her Kitten. So maybe they don't really go together, these 2 colors. I don't know. But I'm going to start with the lip liner. It's a very pretty color. Okay, so what I'm noticing right now that I've filmed, my lips are a little bit dry. When I film then in with a lip liner, a lot of the time you can kind of see that. But this is creamy enough, you don't see it. But honestly, it should be like that, because it's the most expensive lip liner that I have, let's just say that. But that is okay. Okay, so this is the liner. I think it's a pretty color, even for me. Now, Mel was, as far as I know, not an olive. And this was her, I think, her perfect nude lip liner. But even on me, it's pretty. Yeah, I forgot to mention that, didn't I? The slightly orcish part means I'm an olive. So if you're an olive, you're slightly orcish. It feels very, very luxe. And I love it when they have a magnet. Oh, wow. Here's the color. Now, being... slightly olive, even though I'm on the warmer side, it could be that this is a bit too much, because I'm also a delicate olive. That means that muted colors look a little bit more flattering on me, and very bright popping colors kind of tend to take me over. Not that I care that much, but that's I don't have a bright orange like this, so let's see how it looks. How does it look? I think it actually looks... I did not expect it to look this flattering. I thought it would really... Well, it kind of does take me over, because you can, when you look at me now, you see the lip. But the color itself, I think it's very pretty. So that's good, because I wanted to kind of use this one to build a look around, because I have no idea what I want to put in my eyeballs. Let's start with priming. Maybe that's a better idea. So I'm going to prime with my Natasha Denona eyeshadow primer, because that's the primer that I love to use. I don't know if you can hear, one of my cats is upstairs and he's very much snoring. So if you can hear some weird kind of wheezing noise on the background, it's the cat. I don't know if you can hear it though. I can. It just means that he's very, very, that he's sleeping very, very deeply. And that if I want to wake him up, I really have to tap him. Because he, I remember the very first time that he did that. It scared me shitless. I thought he died. But he didn't. I thought there was something very, very wrong with him. But it's just the way that he sleeps. And also, my red one tends to sleep with his eyes open, which is also very, very freaky.
He's a wizard, Harry.
I think that's it. Yeah. Okay. This, and then just with falsies and the liner, I'm almost tempted to do that. Also kind of tempted to kind of recreate what she has here. I found a palette that I can use. It's also new. It's this one from Nomad. The Venice Simplon Express. And fun fact is that it actually contains all my favorite shades of the Orient Express. The green and then this gorgeous duochrome and the red. And so yeah, so let me... I think I'm just going to do a very simple... I think I'm going to do a very simple neutral look. I know who am I, but it's what I'm feeling with this eye look. Sometimes it just happens. And let's kind of chat then about the fact that I am allowing myself to love neutrals. And yes, there is a reason that I'm saying it like that. Because it's true. Because, you know, when I started, I'm going to do a very, very basic neutral eye look. I'm not really going to point out the shades because there are two true neutrals here. Maybe I will... Yeah, I'm basically, the plan is I'm going to go to Baby Grand, which will pull maybe a little bit peachy on me. We shall see. And then I'm going to deepen it up with this. On my lid, maybe this one. I think it's going to be something like that. Maybe I will pull in the black from there, from another palette, to deepen it up even more if I want to. I'm also planning a wing. That's the plan. So yeah. So why am I saying... let me zoom you in. Why am I saying allowing myself to love neutrals again? Well, basically when I started my makeup journey, I have always loved pink eyeshadow and I have always loved purple eyeshadow. So I was kind of into the color as well. Purple was actually for me, it still felt like a neutral. I felt comfortable in purple. And I felt comfortable in specific kinds of pink. Not very, very hot pink, but a little bit more the pink that is in here. So maybe a little bit more like this, you know, the peachier pink, the orangier pink. Now I know why, then I didn't. But yeah, so when I started makeup, when I started really watching makeup content and started watching YouTube, people said that if you are above a certain age, you should stick to your neutrals. Because
it's just not flattering. You cannot do it anymore. Stay in your own lane.
You know, those types of things. And I have always loved a neutral look on someone else. But yeah, I love to be a rebel. What can I say? Did you guess that I love to be a rebel? So I was like, what the hell are you telling me that I cannot do that? I will make my own mind up if I can or cannot do that. So I branched out to color. And I felt like then I felt like I had to, you know, and don't get me wrong, I still love color. And I will always love color, but I don't necessarily need to do a colorful eye makeup to feel a certain way, if that makes any sense. So what basically happened for me a lot of the time, doing a very bold look, same with my hair, you know, it makes a statement and people look at you and I know why they are looking at me. That was kind of the gist of it a little bit. And it's also, you know, that getting in touch with your feminine side, and even if it is then through makeup, which maybe a lot of people find feminine anyway, there is a lot of strength in femininity, but it's strength that has been oppressed in me by me. Let me just say it like that. And for the first time in, now as long as I can remember, I am finally there that I'm like, you know what? It's time for my softer side to shine, for the feminine side to shine. And that's why I say I'm finally letting myself love neutrals as well, because when you do a neutral look, it's at least for me, the way that I do my neutral looks, is it enhancing? Yes, but I can also make depth and dimension with color, so it's not necessarily that. But there's just a certain power in this as well, you know. And even if it is with a softer lip or something like that. And I'm not talking about no makeup, because if I'm doing no makeup, I'm doing no makeup, you know. Maybe brows and a lip gloss. That's then basically it. So it's not about that. It's not about minimal makeup. It's just about expressing yourself and what you feel comfortable in. And I just felt that I needed to, you know, kick against the system, anarchy rules, that kind of thing. And now I am in a position that I'm like, I don't care if anyone feels that I should not wear blue. If I want to wear blue, I'm going to do it. And I did that anyway, but I did it more from the standpoint of, so you're saying I cannot do that, so let me show you what I can, you know. And now I'm just doing what I want to do. And if I feel like wearing blue on a certain day, I will. And if I don't feel like wearing blue on a certain day, I won't. If I feel like I really want to do a neutral makeup look, especially with this eye look or with this lip look, because I think it will look stunning, then I will do that. I am just, I don't know, I'm really loving the softer makeup looks as well lately. Now, I'm not saying that you should. You do you, and I've said that from the beginning, you do you. Am I going to stop doing colorful looks? No. Also, I do have to say that my neutral looks are not everyone's neutral looks. My neutral looks are, I think you can consider it glam. That's basically my everyday. But on the other hand, I can also go out in bright red eyeshadow. Because honestly, the moment that I step downstairs, unless it's a special effects makeup, but the moment I step outside of this room and I'm putting on my jacket and I'm going to go outside, I basically forget what I have on my eyes. That's me a lot of the time. So it has also happened that someone said, I love your eye makeup. And then I was like, what do I have on my eyes? So yeah, so basically because I am allowing my softer side out, I think it coincided with everything. And that just comes from confidence. You know, I am confident enough in myself, in my own ability. I'm going to use the shade Nightcap, which is the darkest brown. But I'm going to spray it for underneath my eye. My friend Debbie does this. And it really helps. It not only helps to intensify the shade, but it also helps to have it stick and minimize fallout. I will link Debbie's channel down below. It's Debutante. I think some of you will already know her. And some of you might not. If you will basically... Oh yeah, and also for my cool-toned olive peeps. I have a few channels for you. So I have Queer Bones, which is one of my subscribers. And they are so, so cool. They are medium cool olive. And then I have my friend Debbie, who is a light cool olive. So I will list both channels down below. Go check them out. They are all very, very good humans. Love color. So, and definitely, definitely worth checking out. Okay. But fun fact also, for me, neutrals, I had to learn how to read neutral shades. Because I have always seen color combinations. I see what color combinations I can make work, what I cannot make work, what I can mix, what I cannot mix. And if I am not sure if I can or cannot mix anything, something, I will just mix it on my hand, for instance, you know, that kind of thing. With neutrals though, I kind of had to learn, because for me it's not that natural. And now I understand why, because what I'm putting on my eyes now, the brown, it's not my neutral, because my neutral is green. Or olive, in at least light olive, you know, that's my true neutral, because I'm not a brown, my undertone is olive, that is what I mean. So if you are an olive and you want to have the perfect, at least for me, neutral palette from Nomad Cosmetics, this one, is it? The Malibu quad. Because this, can you see the shades? Can you see the difference? Very green, right? For me, they are neutrals. These are my perfect neutral shades. These are a little bit warmer olive. Cool-toned olive. Sigil has a cool-toned olive palette, which is the tender scent gazelle. I think I'm kind of getting ready for my close-up, Mr. DeMille. It's a little bit more intense than I kind of had planned with this eye look. But what can you do about it? I do kind of want a little bit of black. I have a palette here that has black in it. I'm just going to grab a hint of black from that palette. It does not matter what palette you grab. I'm just going to grab this palette. It's the Batman palette from Makeup Revolution. Very nice black, but I want a hint. Okay, I'm just going to work that in a little bit. Now, what I also could have done was just falsies and a wing. And I love that. I love that look as well. With a passion. I think that's so, so pretty. The only downside is that for me, because my eye shape is the way that it is, basically deep set and a little bit older, if I do that, I kind of lose definition in my eyes. So a lot of the time, I will just put a hint of something in the crease. It can be a bronzer. Have I put on powder bronzer? No. I failed to put on powder products because I really did not think, knew what I wanted to do highlighter-wise. I still don't really. And it's all... Oh, yeah. Let's do this one. Yes, I know I'm all over the place. What can I say? I said I have ADHD, right? Well, that's basically what's happening. Let's go to this one. This is from DJ's Unique Boutique. And it's such a stunning, stunning highlighter. Flattering for, yeah, I'm going to say it, all skin tones, all skin depths, all undertones. It's just, oh. I will link it down below. I have a code with DJ. And I did get this in PR. It's a loose highlighter, but... It is stunning. You get a crepton also. I will show. This is what you get. It's a crepton. Let's put it there because that's what I used. And then I'm going to grab a bigger brush. Going to blend over it. Okay, that's kind of it. I think I'm going to go to the shade Bar 36 and something else. I'm going to put that on the lid. So yeah, what is my message with this? Just enjoy, have joy in what you smear on your eyeballs. That is it. If you have joy doing a neutral look or doing a very much a blue look or purple look or a blue and purple or a purple, or you get my drift, right? Enjoy what you do. Have joy in what you are doing. That is the most important thing. And if someone says to you, you cannot wear this or that, unless it is for work or something like that, you know, do what makes you happy. Do what makes you happy. Even me, you know, if I now I would never say to someone, you should wear this or that, but don't feel obligated to do something just because I'm doing it. Does that make any sense? Because that's not what I want. I also have multi-chrome liners here. But I have one that is... Let's see what it does in the waterline. Ooh, that's pretty. This one is for 50-50 Makeup. These are her new liners. Okay, and this is shade 9. Yeah, shade 9. Very pretty. Let's, for funsies, grab the shade London from the palette. Doesn't have to be super intense. This is kind of the shade a little bit of my highlighter, I think. Okay, this is very cute. See, let's kind of brush it over a tad. Just lightly, just a little bit in the inner corner. Cool, okay. Wings and such. I used shade 9, right? Where did I put shade 9? Because it needs to go in the basket.
She puts the lotion in the basket. Otherwise she gets the hose again.
It's kind of like my house. It's not true though. I was joking. Okay, so yes, I want a wing. I want a normal, regular, basic ass black wing. So I need a magnifying mirror for that. I don't know if you can see what I'm doing. I hope you can. Otherwise, I'm sorry. You can, right? So basically I have a mirror in front of me like that. So I have it tilted down. I always start with my left eye. Don't ask. So basically I do a line first. I'm trying to take my time. And I always go a little bit thicker in the outer corner. Let's do that first. Let's show you on this eye as well. Now the liner that I have, can you see what I'm doing? If I'm like this? You cannot, right? I need to go up a bit. Okay. Yes, and I also kind of usually try to support my hand a little bit on the table or on my face. So I hope you can see what I'm doing. Again, I'm just painting a line. I do have a video on my channel how I do my whale tail. It's still basically the same thing. Well, it is actually still exactly the same thing. So this is what I have now. Yes, then I try to kind of get them even a little. Usually I go in a little bit more in the inner corner. And I basically try to line up my brush with my lashes. Oh Lord, but there I go again. I'm not paying attention. So now I have to make the line thicker. Oh yes, and blink without a brush on your eye. I have to say that to myself constantly as well. Usually it goes okay. Sometimes it doesn't. So then I'm just basically looking to see if the lines are thick enough on both sides. Okay, now comes the hard part. Well, the hard part is always to get them even. But what I want is the wing, right? But because my eyes are deep set and older, I have folds everywhere. I'm going to ignore them. So what you're going to do is you're going to, with your eyes relaxed, look in the mirror. And the best part is to look straight on. So let's see if I can achieve that, to look straight on. And what I do is I go from the bottom. I take my bottom lid and then I go up and out. So I line the brush up with my waterline here, with that part. That's what I line my brush up with. I paint a line. Like that. Can you see where it is? So it's here and here. But can you see what's already happening, that skipping? That is just, we're going to ignore that. Usually still paint it. Go away. I still paint it with my eyes relaxed, but I'm just going to extend the line. Most challenging part is always to get them even. And what is important with my eyes relaxed is that it is straight. That's what I'm looking for. The rest I'm forgetting. I will get there later. So now what I'm going to do now is I'm going to connect it again. I'm just going to look forward with my eyes relaxed and I'm going to connect the wing back. To my eyelid, kinda. So here I have done that. Can you see? But when I look this, can you see what's happening there? Well, that's what's happening. With an older eyelid, or you know, if you have folds or hood or whatever. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to fill everything in. But if I just fill in the wing part, this is what you're getting. That's what we want. So now with my eyes stretched, I'm going to fill that part in. And I'm going to connect it to my eyelid, but I'm going to connect it in a circle like that. Because if I do not, I have to make my entire eyelid black. So I basically have a wing like that, a bat wing. Because now if it's dry and I'm just, let me try it a little bit quicker. If I look like this now, you can see that it connects, right? And if I were to do this and then connect it, it would do weird things. Trust me. And if you don't trust me, then try it. Now I'm going to make it a little bit thicker, but I'm going to leave that gap here. Okay, and then I'm looking again. Is it the way that I want it? I want it to line up, and there's a dip in it. I can see that. So this is better. Okay. And then I usually give it a point just to make it nice. But if I look down, it's still nice, you know? And then you have this. And then when I do that, you have that. Now it's time for falsies. So, what the falsies? Let's do the iconics, because I think they're cutesy. Okay, let's get the glue. For my falsies, I also have a video on my falsies, but I do have a video on my falsies, but I'm doing this now anyway. And what I do is I paint. I have here the black duo glue today. But I paint the glue on my lashes, or at least just above, you know, where I'm going to put falsie. So not in my eye, preferably. I can also put a little bit of glue on the falsie band if I want to. Okay, so here you have the falsie, right? I have the glue, preferably without the hair, and I just paint. A little bit of the glue on, and then if you see, I don't know if you can see this, but I want to paint it here a little bit on the back side actually of the glue. I hope you saw that. You don't have to put a glob on, especially not if you're doing it like this. Now, if you are just painting your falsie, you put a little bit more glue on. How much glue? I don't know. It kind of depends. It depends on how much the falsie band will absorb. It depends on how much glue you need for it to stick. So you kind of have to experiment with it. What is important though, if you're wearing falsies, is not only to make sure that they are short or long enough for your eyes, so that they don't, if they go too far in, you can feel it when you're blinking, and that's very, very annoying. If you're putting on the glue, you have to let it sit to get tacky. Now, I know that the glue that I am using, I know when it is tacky. For the black one, when it goes on, it's dark blue. Now it's almost black, and now it's very, very sticky. So I'm just going to line it up. I'm going to look down, line it up with my something. I usually try to kind of line it up with my outer part a little, because I don't want my falsie to go too far in. Well, because I already have the glue where I want my falsie, I don't know, for me it's just easier to do it this way. It's also quicker. It might not be for you, but it is at least something that you can try. Now, if my glue doesn't have a brush applicator, I use kind of a brush like this. Something like that I use then. I have it like this. So now I'm going to go over my nose. Again, I'm going to look down. They always say line it up with your center eye, but I usually line it up a little bit behind the center on the outside. I don't know why, but that's what I do. And then I grab the outside first. And just make sure that I press it on my lid. Then the inside. And it's... I only can do this with this hand. I don't know what it is. But basically I'm grabbing the false and I'm pushing it against my eyelid now. And then I just make sure that it is sticking in the inside. Am I always... are they always placed well? No. Sometimes I take them off again because I'm like, that's not good at all. So you may also have noticed that I haven't put on mascara yet. Now I'm actually going to pinch the falsie a little bit more towards my lashes. And there's a reason that I don't do that. Why? Because when you have mascara on and you're using the method that I am, it's a little bit more difficult to not smear your entire lashes full with glue. And if you don't have the glue, if you don't have your lashes sticking up, it's easier to see where you need to place the falsie. Now, if you are one of those person, if you're a type that needs to curl your lashes, yeah, I don't know. Then just try it, because I never curl my lashes. So, okay, now I'm going to apply mascara. And I know people are like screaming, you should not do that with your falsies. I agree, but I have a specific type of mascara that works very well with my falsies. And I don't really paint my falsies. I just lightly coat my own lashes black a little. That's what I do. I have this mascara, the Bye Bye Panda Eyes from Essence. This is a tube mascara and it doesn't eat up my falsies. So, I'm just going to very lightly... Again, I just want to paint my own lashes black. If I can find them, there they are. A lot of the times I just use the tip of the brush and just blend them into my own, to my falsies a little bit better. And then here it is, the look of today. Oh, I actually forgot to do that. What I usually also do, and I didn't right now, is put a little bit of eyeliner back on top of the lash band. I don't feel like I really need to right now. So that is good. So yeah, this is it. So let me go over the things that are new that I use, which is almost everything. Foundation that I have on is from Glam Shop, and it will be listed, the rest of the makeup will be listed down below as well. The lippy. Let's start with the lippy. The lip liner. I think it's a very pretty color on me as well. With this lippy, maybe it's a little bit too light with this lippy. I knew that. I just wanted to have this combination. What can I say? The lippy is very nice and I want to say creamy, but it's not as creamy as I thought it would be. It could be that it is because it's on top of the liner. So I am going to keep on testing both. I think that the color is very pretty. And I'm pleasantly surprised because I did not know that this color... I didn't know it would look this good on me, honestly. Is it a bright lip? Yes, but it's... I did not know that I would like this type of orange this much on me, honestly. And I do, so that is very good and I'm going to keep on trying it more. Then the multi-chrome liner. I think it's a very, very pretty liner. And it reminds me a little bit of the highlighter that I have on. The only thing is, you see that sticker here? That sticker is, it's the shade number, it's not on the component. And so I basically tore off the sticker from the box and put it on here so I know which one it is. Now, if you don't have a channel and you don't have to list the makeup that you have, then it doesn't matter. For me, it kind of does. So I hope that in the future she is able to print the shade numbers or names on the component itself instead of like this. But yeah, I like it. I don't know how long it will stay for. I will keep on trying it. How's the wing? The wing is okay. Okay, that was that. What else was new? Yeah, the Nomad palette, right? Yeah, it's their normal nomad quality. I did not expect any less. It's the same type of quality as is in the Orient Express because they're the same shades. They're just curated down a little bit because it was a collaboration with Ipsy. I do like this though. I actually like this one better than the big one. First off, because it has all the shades that I really like from this, which is basically those. And as I said, I'm learning to love neutrals as well. And this is a very, for me, a very much curated neutral palette with some colors in it as well. The bigger one, especially with the line, I just got overwhelmed with where I needed to play. So yeah, I really, really like this. And I think that I will use this a lot more than the bigger one. And then that is going to be it for today. Yeah, everything I use will be listed down below in the description box. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. What is it?
Yeah, going well.